The word pickle comes from the Dutch pekel or German pokel, meaning salt or brine. Two very important components of the pickling process. Pickles date as far back as 5,000 years ago when they were used in native India for pickling cucumbers. Throughout history, pickling was a necessity because it was one of the earliest mobile foods that could be stored for a long period of time, especially used by sailors and travelers when they went on long journeys. Families used pickles to store food during cold winter months. Aristotle praised the health benefits of pickled cucumbers. The Romans imported all sorts of foods from the countries they conquered, pickling them for the journeys in vinegar oil brine and even honey. In his famous 1492 voyage, Columbus rationed pickles for his sailors to prevent them from getting scurvy. He even grew cucumbers during a pit stop in Haiti to restock for the rest of the voyage. Amerigo Vespucci, the famous explorer after whom the United States has been named, was a well-known pickle merchant. Napoleon understood the health benefits of pickles for his army and set down a prize money of $250,000 for anybody who could come up with a unique method of preserving and storing foods. Thomas Jefferson wrote, "On a hot day in Virginia, I know nothing more comforting than a fine spiced pickle. Brought up trout, like from the sparkling depths of the aromatic jar below the stairs of Aunt Sally's cellar." Pickles are created by immersing nutrient-rich fruits and vegetables in an acidic solution or a saltwater brine until they are no longer raw or vulnerable to spoilage. This process is called lacto-fermentation and it relies on beneficial cultures such as those found in yogurt or sourdough bread to break down natural sugars into acetic acid, lactic acid, carbon dioxide and other beneficial substances. And it is lactic acid that gives the pickles its great aroma and raw flavor. Today, there are only a few companies which use lacto-fermentation in making pickles. This traditional process went quickly out of favor with the advent of the industrial food production. Modern pickling methods such as use of vinegar, pasteurization, produces a uniform flavor and a larger shelf life, which is more favorable and used by the food production companies. We start by cutting two raw mangoes into small pieces. Then we add 1.5 tablespoons of salt, which absorbs excess water from the fruit, inhibiting growth of bacteria and allowing for the longer shelf life. Then we add 1 tablespoon of turmeric powder to help bring out the yellow color and also because of its health benefits. After leaving the mangoes mixed in salt and turmeric in the sun for 5 hours, this is what we see. Water has traveled from the fruit to the salt crystals, and this passage of water, called osmosis, occurs because of the tendency of substances to move through a membrane from a region of high concentration to a region of lower concentration. In this case, the salt crystals have lower water concentration than the water in the fruit, so water flows out of the mango, diluting the salt crystals. Then we add 1/4 cup of fennel seeds. And 1/4 cup of oil. with 2.5 tablespoons of pickle spice, which can contain mustard seeds, coriander, bay leaves, cloves, black pepper. About 1 tablespoon of chili powder is also added. All of these act as antimicrobial herbs, which inhibit growth of bacteria and allow for the pickle's longer shelf life. And store it in a sterilized glass jar in a cool, dry space. And there you have it, your very own homemade, delicious mango pickle. We start by bringing 5 lemons to a boil in 4 cups of water. Lemons on the gas for about 20 minutes or until they easily give way under the pressure of your thumb. Scoop them into a bowl and let them cool. Then cut them into quarters. The bowl will allow us to save the juices that will come out of the lemons for the pickle. Then we add 2 tablespoons of lemon juice, which aids in the process of osmosis. And then 2 teaspoons of chili powder for the flavor. I also added 3 teaspoons of salt and 1 cup of caster sugar to balance out the sour and spicy flavors. Finally, we transfer the contents of our bowl into a sterilized glass jar, and there we have our very own homemade instant lemon pickle. In the Pacific Islands, where the temperature is really hot and humid, food spoilage is a big problem. So people there have been preserving food in fermentation pits for 2 millennia. They use the surplus food whenever they have a ceremony or in case of a natural catastrophe. They line these chambers with banana leaves to protect it from the soil, and it forms a really important part of their culture. In Fiji, this is so important that before a man can propose to a woman, her parents go and inspect his fermentation pits to make sure that he's good. When the English arrived in the New World, they brought their method for preserving sweet pickles with vinegar, sugar, and spice syrup. Eastern Europeans introduced various methods of making lacto-fermented cabbage. The French served tiny spiced cornicons with heavy pastas. In the Middle East, pickle can be made from anything, from peppers to olives to lemons, and are served with every meal. The Russians pickle tomatoes amongst other things. The Koreans have their kimchi. The Japanese pickle plums and daikon. And the Italians pickle eggplants and peppers.